Hey, what's up? Welcome back. Patrick here from All Things Mathematics, and moving on to the next example on the test. So we have to find these two limits over here. So starting with this first one, we got the limit as x approaches 0 of 3 over x, and then in brackets 1 over x plus 1 plus 1 over x minus 1. So notice here, can't do a direct substitution, right? That's the first thing we always check. Why not? Well, because this denominator here would be 0, right? If we plug in that 0 for x. Over here, it won't be. It will be 1. Over here, it will be negative 1, so that's fine. But over here, it's going to make this limit undefined. And so what we have to do is maybe somehow try to algebraically manipulate this, and hopefully at some point we could cancel out this x. And so what I'm noticing that we can maybe do is we could take these two expressions that are fractions, so let's write them on the side actually, and we can combine them into one. And if we combine them into one, let's see what happens there. So to combine these, what we would have to do is we have to get a common denominator, right? So we would multiply this x plus 1 by this x minus 1. These are two different factors, so we're going to have to multiply them for the lowest common denominator, and then this x minus 1 multiplied by x plus 1, like that. So we'll have x plus 1, x minus 1, and then we'll have 1 times x minus 1, so it's just x minus 1 plus x plus 1 in brackets right there. And then the negative 1, positive 1, those cancel out. We end up with 2x over x plus 1, x minus 1, right? So this entire expression over here, let's go back to the main limit. We've got the limit as x approaches 0. We got 3 over x, and then over here, this entire bracket simplified to 2x over x plus 1, x minus 1, like that. And notice what happens. The x's cancel out, right? And so we end up with the limit as x approaches 0, 3 times 2, which is 6, over x plus 1, x minus 1. And we could plug in 0 now, right? So nothing, it would be undefined here. So we'd have 0 plus 1, which is 1, times 0 minus 1, which is negative 1. So this would end up being 6 over negative 1, which is negative 6, right? So that would be the answer for the first limit. Now moving on to the second limit. So we have the limit as x approaches negative 3 of x cubed plus 27 over x cubed minus 9x. Now, first thing, always check direct substitution. Notice that won't work, right? We would get 0 in the numerator, which is fine, but we also get 0 in the denominator, right? This would be negative 27 minus 9 times negative 3 is positive 27. So we'd get 0 in the denominator as well. So that there is not going to work. And we're going to actually have to solve this limit here with factoring, right? So notice that the numerator here, this x cubed plus 27, that's actually going to be a difference of, sum of cubes, right? So if you remember a sum of cubes, if we have a cubed plus b cubed, what's the formula for that? A plus b, a squared minus ab plus b squared, like that. So let's write this x cubed plus this 27, we can rewrite it as 3 cubed, like that. So that's going to be x plus 3. Then over here, we'll have x squared minus 3 times x plus 3 squared, like that. So it's equal to x plus 3, x squared minus 3x plus 9, right? So that right there is going to be the sum of cubes, the limit as x approaches negative 3 of x plus 3, x squared minus 3x plus 9. So that's what the numerator is going to factor into. Now let's see what the denominator factors into. Let's maybe do it with a different color. So we'll have x cubed minus 9x. We could take out an x, x squared minus 9, and then notice that's a difference of squares, right? X minus 3x plus 3, like that. So the denominator factors into x times x minus 3x plus 3. And then cancel, like that. And now we can go into plugging in negative 3 for the rest of the x value. So we'll have negative 3 squared, right, in this bracket, minus 3 times negative 3 plus 9 all over negative 3. And then this will be negative 3 minus 3, like that. So this is going to be 27 over negative 18, like that. Hold up. No, positive 18, right? You got to be careful. Negative 6 times negative 3 is positive 18, right? So the final answer, you can divide both these by 9, so 3 over 2. That ends up being the final answer for this limit. And that's a wrap for the video. Hopefully you enjoyed that. If you want to see more videos like this, please go to my website, allthingsmathematics.com. Over there, all of the videos are organized by chapter, by section. If you feel like you need tutoring at any point, you could also hit me up. My contact details are on the website. Enjoy your day, and I'll see you in the next one. Peace out.